a breakup, that's cool. No, I won't blame you. It was fun, girl. Don't say no, 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 no. Just say yeah, 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 yeah. And we'll go, 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 go. If you're ready, like I'm ready. Cause it's a beautiful night. We're looking for something dumb to do. Hey, baby, I think I wanna marry you.
Tonight, Freddie and Jenny, in celebration of their love, has now chosen this time to honor their relationship by formally uniting as husband and wife in holy matrimony. And it is truly my honor to welcome each and every one of you on this wonderful evening. We begin this ceremony tonight by honoring someone who's no longer with us. Freddie and Jenny wanted to take just a moment to honor the memory of Jenny's father, Werner, whom she loved very much. While he cannot be here in mind and body, I'm sure he is here in spirit, and his blessings overlies this ceremony and this marriage. It has turned into a beautiful evening, as I'm sure you will all agree. And for those of us down front, it just got about 8 degrees warmer with the entrance of this most gorgeous, beautiful bride. Do you not agree? You want to give show her a little love? How about her, Freddie?
Yeah.
As some of you know, criminal justice was their major at Cal State Fullerton, so that put them together in a department of study. But this was not going to be like something in a movie where Freddie walks into study hall and suddenly they gaze at one another and go running to each other in slow motion. No, it was not going to be like that at all. Of course, I realized that this may have been something to do with it, that Freddie always sat front row center, so he really couldn't see behind him, you know, what was going on. So I teased him about that a little bit, and then, you know, wanting to be teacher's pet, you know, and have all the answers. But in his defense, he did tell me, he said, well, you see, Brent, you know, you just don't see females in some of these courses, as they're rather gritty and, you know, rather raw, you know, criminal justice. There's a couple titles of classes. I was almost embarrassed. Well, fate must have stepped in somehow, because one semester, one classroom filled up so fast that the school had no choice but to move the students to a larger classroom. But by the time Freddie got there in the larger room, the front row was already filled up, forcing him to the second row, or maybe the third row for that matter. But there, seated in a couple rows back, was lovely Jenny. And it was his good fortune there was an empty seat next to her. He did not need a house to fall on his head. He grabbed the chair right away. Are you kidding? Freddie initiated some chat. Jenny mentioned that, I think I have you in at least one or a couple of other classes. And Freddie couldn't really recall that. Of course, she understood that, since he was always front row center, never turning around. Well, they got on well and talking a bit. You have to realize, Freddie thinks a step or two ahead. And he knew that this class was going to be a tough one, and that also they were already facing a big test early in the semester. So he suggested to Jenny she'd maybe consider forming a little study group, just the two of them.
That was a good one, Freddy.
Really good. Well, Jenny realized too, yeah, this is a toughie, and he doesn't, you know, look exactly offensive. So why not? You know, why can study with him? Well, Freddy just told me actually yesterday, he honestly felt he won the lottery, because she said, well, you probably better have my number if we're going to study. Yeah, another good one, Freddy. Yeah. And you see, sometimes when we least expect it is when life sneaks up and do something wonderful in our lives. And that is exactly what happened here. So a casual school friendship began to develop. And during this early phase of the friendship, Freddy could not help but notice Jenny's computer or laptop, which they both sort of described to me as very large and cumbersome and old school. And at the time, some of you may know, Freddy was one of the top tech guys at Fry's and had the access to the best possible equipment available. He just fell in his heart, this woman needs a little better technology here. And the timing was really ideal for him, because he'd been wanting and waiting for a moment to let Jenny know he was really starting to like her and he wanted to get to know her better. But every time there was a moment to tell her, he said he kind of became tongue-tied, you know? He could recite the Constitution, but he couldn't say, I like you and I'd like to go out with you. Well, he decided to buy this present, wrap it in a box, but of course, Freddy, you know, didn't want to make it easy. So he wrapped the box in a box and maybe another box and presented it to Jenny. Said, well, I got something for you. She had no idea, this large box. And so she began to open it and get down to the bottom of it. And she unwrapped an iPad so she could set aside her laptop. And she also opened a card that said, I like you and I want to take you out. Well, Jenny, I think, was floored, frankly, because such politeness she was not accustomed to in 2016, was it? 17? You know what I mean? It sort of seemed politeness from another era. But Jenny thought that was a perfectly fine idea to go out. And when they were working and other classes separated them, they texted, of course. And something had inspired them to begin each text by addressing one another as Mr. Rodriguez and Miss Coffinger. And their friendship began to blossom. It didn't take long for them to realize that this friendship held the promise of something much more than a passing acquaintance, which I know pleased them both. And the more they learned about each other, with similar goals and similar outlook on life, before long it was just undeniable. All at once, life was just a little bit brighter. Everything had just a little bit of sweetness in the air, because they were doing things together and hanging out. And they were precisely where they wanted to be with each other, and they've been together ever since. Freddy is so kind and funny, Jenny told me. And he cooks for me too. Jenny is so optimistic, always sees the positive side of life, and is caring and encouraging. And we do have fun, Freddy told me. And that brings our little love story right here tonight as they stand here preparing to become husband and wife. And now, the moment we've all been waiting for, your vows are about to be exchanged. I begin with a question that I ask each of you first. And I begin with Freddy. Freddy, you take Jenny as your lawfully wedded wife to live together after God's holy ordinance in the state of holy marriage.
Yes, I do.
Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keeping only unto her, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
And Jenny, there he is, Mr. Wright. You take Freddy as your lawfully wedded husband to live together after God's holy ordinance in the holiest state of marriage.
I do.
Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keeping only unto him, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Miss Coffinger, Here we are in front of our family and friends gathered to witness our union in marriage. 258 days have gone by since I went down on one knee before you on top of a hill to propose my genuine love for you. When I met you, I did not have the best fashion sense, but it got slightly better. I always wore basketball shorts to all our classes, as our classmates could possibly tell you, but never played a single game. Yet you saw something in me and took a chance. I promise to always be a devoted friend, husband, and to the best of my abilities, a great father to our future children, as I know you will be a great mother. You are the person that I want to grow old with, but also waking up each morning next to you, telling you how beautiful you look before we start our busy day. What I have learned throughout the course of our relationship is that love is not about how much we do. Love is about how much love we put into what we do. Love is not about winning or losing. It is simply choosing. And dedicating our hearts to each other, no matter where we are or the circumstances we are in. When I say I do, I am committed to you as I choose you to be my wife. Today begins our fairy tale that has no end. I am marrying you without any hesitation or doubt, my love.
Mr. Rodriguez, you have come into my life unexpectedly. When I met you, I was hurt, and I was broken from my father's passing. But without knowing, you helped me overcome my sadness. You came into my life at the right time, like a blessing from the sky. You have been my knight in shining armor. We have spent hours in a day getting to know each other and talking about our future, when we were supposed to be studying. This is when I knew you were the one for me. Never have I met anyone who shares so many common interests as myself. We clicked from the beginning, and I love how you play with your nephews, your cousins, and the other kids. The smile on your face shows all the happiness you have to give, and I cannot wait to see you become a great father. I love that you always open a door for me, like a true gentleman. I love the face you make when I always prove to you that I'm right. Even when I'm wrong, I'm right. I love the man that you have become, that works hard and never gives up on his goals. But most importantly, I love that you love me. You are my Prince Charming that every princess dreams to find. I promise to love you and take care of you, so always be true and loyal through sickness and in health for the rest of our life. I love you, Mr. Freddy Rodriguez.
And Felix Cruz will bring forward the rings, please.
This circle, this ring is a circle without end. And my love for you is eternal. With this ring, I give you my heart. I promise with this day forward, you will not walk alone. May my heart be your shelter, and my arms be your home.
Freddy's ring represents the same outward invisible sign signifying Jenny's love for him. So your turn, Jenny. As you're placing the ring on Freddy's finger, you will offer him this second vow, saying,
I give you this ring. Wear it with love and joy. for I choose you to be my husband this day and every day.
I accept this ring. I will wear this with love and joy as I choose you to be my wife this day and every day.
Freddy and Jenny, you'll now take into your care and keeping the happiness of the one person in the entire world you love above all others. You've stood here and agreed to share strength and responsibilities and to share love. So always be sharers of each other's dreams, consolers of each other's sorrows, and helpers in all of life's challenges. Let us pray. Gracious God, hear this prayer now, as we pray that you will bless Freddy as a faithful husband to Jenny. Bless him as the provider of nourishment and sustain him in all the pressures that life brings. May his strength be her protection. May his character be her boast and her pride. May he so live that she will find in him the haven for which the heart of a woman truly longs. Bless Jenny as a loving wife to Freddy. Give her that tenderness that will make her great, that deep sense of understanding and faith in you, Father, so that she can have that inner beauty of soul, that eternal youth that is found in holding fast to the things that never age. May they never minimize or expect perfection of each other than what belongs to you, Father. They will minimize each other's weaknesses, and please be swift to praise each other's points of beauty and strength. Help them to always see each other from the point of view of a lover's kind and patient eyes. Give them enough tears to keep them humble, enough successes so that they know with walk with God. And may they never take each other's love for granted, but always experience that breathless wonder that exclaims, out of all this world, you chose me. And we ask these blessings in the name of our risen Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Now the moment we've all been waiting for. Freddy and Jenny, would you join hands, please? By joining hands with them and by the power of the authority vested in me, I declare you are husband and wife in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Freddy, you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I have the distinct pleasure of introducing you for the very first time to Mr. and Mrs. Freddy and Jenny Rodriguez. There they are! What's really on the inside of your insecurities, of the dirty laundry never made me blink one time. Unconditionally, I will love you.
Darles las gracias a todos, a todas las personas que estamos aquí, que hicieron que este día fuera maravilloso para mi hijo. Gracias por acompañarnos.
What my beautiful mother was trying to say was thank you for coming and making this day special for me and Jenny. I truly appreciate this from the bottom of my heart. Thank you.
Okay, I look to the prayer. I wish you all luck, all in your life. So lucky, Viviana and Iva. You're welcome.
Freddy is the nicest and innocent and one of the generous men that I know. I left California for 5 years and I saw him 6 months ago and I saw him today. Today, and he changed so much. He changed like tremendously. Really good looking, and you know, he used to wear this really baggy clothes. And now he's wearing really nice clothes. But there's one thing he hasn't changed, which is like once he set the goal, he never stopped till he gets that goal. And today, I think he made a new goal, making Jenny happy and have a great family, right? So I guess that's his new goal, and I'm sure he can get, you know, he can grab to it. And I want to congratulate you two and hope you guys make a great, wonderful family. Thank you.
I would like to thank everybody for coming here to celebrate Jenny and Freddie's happiest days of their lives. A couple of months ago, I started thinking of what I would say. I never knew where to start or what to say. Thinking back to our high school days, Jenny has always been very hardworking, loyal, determined, and the biggest princess you will probably ever meet. Thinking back to when Jenny told me that she had met this guy at school that was goal-oriented, a family man, and a sweetheart, I knew he would be the one for her. She has always expressed herself in such a beautiful way of when she talks about Freddy. I know and believe that Freddy will make her the happiest woman on earth, because if you don't, buddy, I will kick your ass. Freddy and Jenny, I would love to wish you both a lifetime filled with nothing but joy and happiness. Cheers to love. Oh, and by the way, I call Godmother your first kid.
I love me. Hey. I love me. Hey. I don't know about you.
Baby, who would make me the better breakfast? Who is the first one that fell in love?
They gon' say all kinds of things. They'll make jokes about my name.
Who has a better shower singing voice? Finally!
Who is the pickiest eater?
I love me. I love me. I don't know about you.
Who would want the kids first? Who's more likely to burn the house down while cooking? Now we know who can cook better breakfast. Who is afraid of heights?
Oh, I love me. Hey. I love me. Yeah. I don't know about you, but baby, I love me.
Who do you trust more behind the wheel? Who do you trust more behind the wheel? Who's the responsible one? Who's the most stubborn? Who takes the longest in a shower? Who's the party animal? Who's the most likely to cry at a movie? Last but not least, who's more likely to leave dishes in the sink?
My dreams, I hope that someday I'll share her home.